This is the inventory overview report for the last 24 months. This report is showing the inventory balance and average minimum maximum balance. Balance variance quarter over quarter percent and stock turnover in days. Moreover, it includes also a lot of other information about inventory aging, which can be seen in the pie chart and these two tables. The same information as in the inventory overview report is provided by year, while more detailed information is provided in the item table. In the item table, we can see all items and different KPIs alongside them. KPIs like net sales variance, next to them are purchase values and the purchase differences over time. Number of days passed since the last sale and or last purchase of every item. So are we delivering items on time? We could argue that we are not, however, our vendors are very accurate in their delivery. We can also see how many days are we delivering late to our customers, while our vendors are also doing good in the KPIs as well. We can compare sales, purchase, and stock quantities, also any other quantity of sales or purchase order. Different pricing, the average stock cost compared to the pricing and stock value. Also, in this particular scenario, aging stock value for items not moving more than a year, turnover in days, and if by any chance some items have been out of stock for more than 7 or 30 days. Now looking into the aging, we can see the value of the stock has decreased over time, going from 4 million to 2 million. Stock turnover days confirm that we are moving items 400 days in the past, and now we are close to 120 days. Unfortunately, this picture shows us that we are very effective by moving items that are already moving less than 100 days a year, but not moving well items that are moving more than a year. And now this present 50% and more. This picture shows us that we have decreased, but not that efficiently, the value of items not moving for a year, and these two lines are much better. Now, in this table is the value of inventory aging by inventory buckets over the year. We do not want to have high values in the buckets more than a year, two, three, four, or more. Now, if we look into the details, even more details can be provided on item levels, where this item's total value is stored in our inventory buckets under 100 days, 100 days to a year, and more than a year. We see the majority is in here. This is the stock quantity, but we also have information about aging stock costs. And we can compare this aging stock cost with the last purchase price and created variance, which means if we sell these items, we lose 30%. And these are much closer to the current price. We also provide the average price, last price, information, and also sales quantity or average selling price. So you can track the aging and prepare to write it off or sell it before it gets too late. There are more reports about turnover, item by date, item charts, and many more to improve the efficiency of your inventory management.